Hi guys, this is Vijay and I hope you're doing well. Today I am going to talk about construction and components of internal combustion engine. Let us start. First of all, what is heat engine? A heat engine is a device in which chemical energy of fuel, it will be converted into heat energy and heat energy into mechanical energy. It is called heat engine. Heat engine can be classified as IC engine and EC engine. Let us start with cylinder block. What is the function of cylinder block? It is the main heart of the engine. It consists of three parts. The first one is the cylinder in which the piston slide up and down. It is called reciprocating motion of the piston inside the cylinder. The second part, the ports or opening for valves in case of two-stroke engine. Third function, the passage for the flow of cooling water from radiator. So radiator is connected with a cylinder block through this passage, and water plus coolant will circulated through the engine body and it will receive the heat from engine block and it will be rejected in atmosphere. The function of the cylinder block is, in the bore of the cylinder, the charge is compressed by piston, ignited and expanded to give power to piston. This is the function of cylinder block. Material used for cylinder block is aluminium alloy and gray cast iron, which has a higher thermal conductivity, as well as aluminium is in light in weight. And the characteristic of gray cast iron is good machinability. Engine head, it is also called cylinder head. It is fitted on top of the cylinder. It has inlet valve, exhaust valve and the spark plug for petrol engine and fuel injector for diesel engine. The function of the cylinder head is, through inlet valve, fresh charge is admitted and through exhaust valve, burnt gases are sent out. Material used for cylinder head is gray cast iron, aluminium alloy and cast steel. The function of the piston is to compress the fresh charge during the compression stroke. Second function, to transmit the force exerted due to combustion of the charge to the connecting rod and finally to the crankshaft during the power stroke. This is the function of piston. Material used for piston is generally aluminium alloy because of light in weight characteristic as well as good thermal conductivity. Cast steel, cast iron and chrome nickel. Combustion chamber. The space enclosed in the upper part of the cylinder by the cylinder head and the piston top during the combustion process is called the combustion chamber. Here the combustion will be take place. So this space is provided in between the piston and cylinder head. So whenever the piston will travel from BDC to TDC, so at that time the sufficient space is there in between the piston and cylinder head for the combustion. If it is not provided, at that time piston will strike with the cylinder head, so it is required. Inlet and exhaust valves. The inlet valve is located at the junction of intake port and cylinder, and the exhaust valve is located at the junction of exhaust port and cylinder. The function of the inlet valve is, allows the fresh charge into the cylinder, and the exhaust valve provide passes for the burnt gases to escape from the cylinder. Material, valves are made of nickel chromium steel, titanium, silicrome steel, etc. Inlet and exhaust manifold. The pipe through which air or air fuel mixture is drawn into the cylinder is called inlet manifold, while the pipe through which the flue gases, exhaust gases, escape into the atmosphere is called the exhaust manifold. Piston ring. There are basically three functions of the piston ring. Piston rings are fitted into the grooves of the piston to maintain good seal between the piston and the cylinder walls. There are two types of piston ring. upper ring are called compressor ring and the lower rings are called oil rings. The function of the piston ring is to increase the compression ratio and to provide the gas tight sealing to prevent leakage of the lubricating oil into the engine cylinder. The second function of the oil rings, also called as scraper rings, are used to distribute and regulate oil within the cylinder wall and help scrape it back into the crankcase. The third function of the piston ring, they also play a major role in the heat transfer process between the piston and cylinder wall. The material used for piston ring are alloy cast iron containing silicon, manganese, alloy, steels, etc. Connecting rod. The connecting rod interconnect the piston to the crankshaft. The upper end of the connecting rod is fitted to the piston and lower end to the crankshaft. The function of the connecting rod is to transmit the power produced in the cylinder to the crankshaft. It converts the reciprocating motion of the piston into rotary motion of the crankshaft. The sliding motion of piston inside the cylinder from to and from means to top dead center to bottom dead center, this is called reciprocating motion. And the function of the connecting rod is to convert the reciprocating motion into rotary motion, because our requirement is to rotate the wheel. So the connecting rod, it will convert the reciprocating motion into rotary motion. Material used for connecting rods are medium carbon steel and alloy steels. It can be produced either by casting, powder metallurgy or forging. Connecting rod for automotive applications are typically manufactured by forging from either steel or powder metal, because in case of a forging process, we can increase the strength of connecting rod. Piston pin. The piston pin is a pin that connects the small end of the connecting rod to the piston. It is also known as gudgeon pin or wrist pin. There are three names: gudgeon pin, wrist pin and piston pin. Piston pins are made of various material. However, the most common material used in the production of piston pin is steel. Crank pin. Crank pin connect the connecting rod big end to the crankshaft. The crank pin are generally made of carbon steel, forged steel and alloy steel. Next part is a crankshaft. The piston, connecting rods and crankshaft together form the crank mechanism. The secondary function of the crankshaft is to transmit power to other engine system, like as valve timing, oil pump, cooling water pump, air conditioning compressor, alternator, etc. Material used for crankshaft is generally forged steel. Camshaft. A camshaft is a shaft on which cams are mounted. The camshaft is driven by crankshaft through timing gears. Here you can see that this is a timing gear. This is a timing belt and this is a timing gear. And the upper side, this is a camshaft, and the lower side, it is crankshaft. The shaft also provides the drive to the ignition system function. It is used to operate the intake and exhaust valve through cam follower, push rod and rocker arm. Material known as high carbon, high copper, chrome, silicon, cast steel is used for making camshaft. Generally, the process for manufacturing of camshaft is drop forging. So drop forging is used for making crankshaft. Cams. Cams are integral part of the camshaft. Cams are designed in such a way that to open the valves at the correct timing and to keep them open for the necessary duration. So it will maintain the time duration for opening and closing of valve. Crankcase. It is a cast iron case which holds the cylinder and crankshaft. It also serves as a sump for the lubricating oil. The material used for crankcase are cast iron and aluminium alloy. Flywheel. The flywheel stores the excess energy during the power stroke. So, during power stroke, the maximum energy it will be released. So the excess energy it will be stored in the flywheel, and flywheel use this energy during compression and exhaust stroke. Thus it is a function is to maintain uniform rotation of the crankshaft. Material used for a flywheel is cast iron. Carburetor. Carburetor is a device in which petrol and air it will mix inside the chamber and it will be supplied to the petrol engine. Carburetor is a device used in petrol engine to mix the air and fuel in proper proportion as per the requirements of an internal combustion engine. For many decades, it was the basic fuel metering system in all automobile engines, but nowadays it is still used in low cost small engine like lawn mowers, two wheelers, etc. But it is uncommon in new automobiles. Fan. Most engines have an engine driven fan to increase airflow through the radiator and through the engine compartment, which increases waste heat removal from the engine. It is a forced convection. Fans can be driven mechanically or electrically and can run continuously or use only when needed. Fuel pump. Electrically or mechanically driven pump to supply fuel from the fuel tank or reservoir to the engine. This is the function of the fuel pump, to supply the fuel from the fuel tank. Many modern automobiles have an electric fuel pump mounted submerged in the fuel tank. Some small engines and early automobiles had no fuel pump, relying on gravity feed. Glow plug. The function of the glow plug is to increase the temperature of the air. In case of a winter season, the temperature of the air is lower. And finally, in case of an IC engine, whatever the reaction will be take place, it is called chemical reaction. And chemical reaction, it will depend on temperature. So whenever the temperature is lower, so reaction is also slow. So at that time, we are facing the problem. Our vehicles are easily not started. So in case of a petrol engine, we operate the choke. But in case of a diesel engine, we are using glow plug to increase the temperature of air. So glow plug is nothing else, it is a heater coil. Whenever the air will pass through this plug, it will increase the temperature of air, and this hot air is supplied to diesel engine or CI engine. It will increase the temperature of air, and this hot air is supplied to CI engine. So the combustion will be take place easily during cold starting. This is the function of glow plug. So small electrical resistance heater mounted inside the combustion chamber of many CI engines used to preheat the chamber enough so that combustion will occur when first starting of cold engine. This is the function of glow plug. The glow plug is turned off after the engine is started. Head gasket. Gasket which serve as a sealant between the engine block and head, where they bolt together. They are usually made in sandwich construction of metal and composite materials. Oil pan. Oil reservoir usually bolted to the bottom of the engine block, making up part of the crankcase. Act as the oil sump for most engines. Oil pump. Pumps used to distribute oil from the oil sump to required lubrication points. The oil pump can be electrically driven, but is most commonly mechanically driven by the engine. Some small engines do not have an oil pump and are lubricated by splash lubrication system.